conversation around video vixen's Kodak's death still continues as the Nigerian police are investigating the real cause of her death. It was earlier reported that Kodak died at the home of popular videographer Clarence Peters in the evening of Sunday, April 29, 2020, from electric shock while charging her phone. People who were present at this unfortunate event have tried to share the real events of the day. According to a crew member, Clarence was not at the scene of Kodak's death. The crew member identified himself as Melvin, stated that the incident happened in the videographer's studio and not his home. He also noted that Clarence's attention was called upon when the incident happened. Meanwhile, it was reported that Clarence was detained by the police over the sad incident. The spokesperson of the Lagos State Police Command, Bala Elakana, revealed that they are still investigating a murder charge, admitting that the video producer was detained. To clarify the issue of his arrest, the videographer's girlfriend, called Jennifer Alegbino, said that he was not arrested nor detained. She explained that he only honored the invitation of the police for questioning. According to her, the police lied about the murder charge, considering the autopsy results is yet to be produced. Clarence Peters has now taken to his official Instagram page to share his own side of the story, reiterating the statement of his crew member that he wasn't at the scene of the incident. The videographer said that his attention was called for and he was told that she collapsed. "We immediately rushed her to the nearest hospital, which refused to let us into their premises, let alone admit her. They assumed she was a COVID-19 patient. We tried, but we were not able to gain entry into a second hospital. We eventually got her to a third hospital, where she was pronounced dead 30 minutes after arrival," he noted. He explained that people who were at the scene of the sad incident said that she was electrocuted and her phone was found on her chest with severe burn marks and the phone's imprint on her chest.
"It's a pity that she's just gone. And it's painful. I just got an information that a lady is posing herself to be me. I am Blessing Talatu Ike, her mother. I've also been told that an account number is online. I've not posted my account number online. The girl seated next to me is her elder sister by the name Shekinah Glory Ike. Please, I want you all to stand up and help me fight. As you can see, I cannot fight."